Can you imagine being born with a disability, making it impossible for you to stand on your own two feet? Lineth Ramirez Morales was born with such a disability. She has a form of Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, or EDS. EDS is the classification for a series of connective tissue disorders caused by faulty collagen. Collagen is the protein that constrains your joints without locking them up, so that you can do things like walk or squat or sit down and stand up again. So what would you do if you were born in a tiny Mexican village with EDS? Perhaps you would do what Lineth has done and join the family business. Lineth lives with her family in a quiet village outside of Oaxaca City that has become famous for its fantastic animal wood carvings. The village is called Erasola, Cuna de los Abriges, cradle of fantastic wooden figures. But its more formal name is San Antonio Erasola. Located about 8 miles outside of Oaxaca City, Erasola is nestled in a hillside below the ruins of the ancient Zapotec city of Monte Albán. This is Mauricio Ramirez and his wife Liliana Morales. Their household is one of many in Erasola that have made a successful cottage industry of carving, sanding, and painting wooden animals for commercial trade. Mauricio is particularly well known for his lizards. Do you see how contorted the lizards are? These lizards and almost all of the animal figures from this region are carved from the wood of the copal tree, which is famous for its twisty, gnarled branches. The wood carvers often speak of being able to see the animal that they will carve in the branches of the copal tree while the tree is still standing. Today, Mauricio is creating an owl. In the tradition of this region, owls are perceived as omens or messengers between humans and the divine. In pre-Columbian times, the owl was equivalent to an angel. Notice that Mauricio is using nothing more than a simple kitchen knife to bring the owl out of the wood, and that he works freehand, without a ruler, to assure that the piece is symmetrical. Although Oaxaqueños have carved animals and other figures from copal for centuries, this activity did not become a significant artistic and commercial enterprise until Manuel Jiménez Ramírez gained international recognition for his work in the 1970s. In a very short time, several villages outside of Oaxaca City became wood carving meccas. Wood carvers can be found in Erasola, San Martin Tilcahete, La Union, Tehelipam, and other villages in the Oaxaca Valley. The artisans in these villages still grow food for their own use and for trade. Many men in Erasola work at the local lumber mill. The supply of copal trees has been drastically reduced by the commercialization of wood carving, and artisans must seek supplies further and further away from their villages. In Erasola, a reforestation effort is underway to assure an ongoing local supply of copal. When Mauricio is finished carving, he hands his work over to Liliana, who will sand the piece to a smooth finish using increasingly fine grains of sandpaper. Sanding is a very important step in the production process. This is the detailed work that can turn a casual toy into a work of art. The completed carvings are dipped in a mixture of insecticide and gasoline to kill any bugs in the wood and to discourage other bugs from disturbing the carvings. The overall finish of a piece, prior to painting, may be further enhanced with the use of copal resin or plastiloca to fill cracks or to attach limbs, wings, antlers, claws, spikes, or tails to the animals. When it comes to painting, each artisan cultivates his or her own style. Some artisans are known for their use of soft, natural colors, and some are known for their use of bright, metallic, or even neon colors. Some decorate their animals with geometric pre-Columbian motifs. Some use organic motifs, highlighting the local flora. If you were born into a family of artisans, you will learn the family trade, even if you plan to go to veterinary school someday. Here, Liliana is putting her 7-year-old daughter, Melissa, to work sanding an owl. When the sanding, fumigation, and resin work are complete, the piece will have a very smooth finish, like the lizard shown here. The finished, painted pieces will be signed by Mauricio and go to market. Once Lineth has given her okay. Some artisans sell their work directly to the public, and some sell through dealers. When sales are slow and finances are tight, an artisan may sell his work to a local middleman who signs the work with his own name. This is Victor Vazquez Davila in his shop in Oaxaca City. Victor started out as a watchmaker and repairer with a shop in the heart of Oaxaca's tourist district. But once Victor began selling carved wooden animals from the nearby villages in his shop, he was quickly diverted. The precision required for watchmaking proved to be a superb foundation for the intricate painting he does today. Some say that there is a spirit hiding in each of the carved wooden animals. Perhaps you, like Victor, will be unable to resist their charms.